Hey guys, Penny is here. Sorry. Okay. Bean, you gotta decide if you wanna hang out with mom or if you wanna go watch the squirrels. Now would be the time to make that decision. Hey everyone, welcome back to today's video. My name is Cassie. If you are new here, I am a professional hairstylist and makeup artist, and I also like to film fashion and beauty content on the side. So if you like today's video and you like what you see and you want to see more, feel free to subscribe or give this video a thumbs up so I can keep filming good content for you guys. But today's video, as you guys can tell by the title, is a hair 101 video. So since we have all the time in the world and we have time to kind of take care of ourselves a little bit better, since we're all at home and we're not really going anywhere, I figure this is the perfect time to film a video talking all things hair and hair health. I get asked a ton of questions, basically on the regular, on how to keep your hair healthy, what to do to get your hair in a healthier state, and any tips and tricks that I have. So I'm gonna lay it all out on the line for you guys and tell you everything I know. And maybe some of these things you guys probably have already known before, but maybe you're gonna learn something new today. Who knows? But I hope you guys enjoy this video. And also at the end of the video, I did ask you guys to ask me any questions on Instagram that you may have for me to touch base on in this video. So all the questions that you guys asked will be at the end of the video, so stay tuned for that as well. But yeah, if you guys want to know more about hair health and treating your hair better, and just basically getting stronger, healthier hair, just keep on watching. Okay, so I literally sat down yesterday and I wrote down everything that we need to talk about. Everything. So tip number one is to go longer without washing your hair. I highly recommend this tip. If you're washing your hair every single day, please stop doing that. You're actually doing more damage than you think you are. It's actually making your hair become a little bit more brittle. You're stripping the hair of its natural oils. I'm sure you've heard that before. And when I talk to clients and they say, well, I can't stop, my hair just gets so greasy, 100% I understand that, but it's because you're overdoing it with your hair. You're overwashing it. So if you can start going every other day and maybe add every 2 days, that is amazing in itself. Just keeping those oils in your hair a little bit longer is so beneficial. When you're washing your hair too much, your hair is just going to become so brittle and it's just not going to, things are not going to go the way you want it to. So I'm gonna break this down between hair types, so this is maybe more helpful for you guys. If you have fine hair, I would highly recommend washing your hair every other day or every 2 days. If you can go every 2 days, that's amazing. Dry shampoo is gonna be your best friend no matter what hair type you have. So dry shampoo, highly recommend. And my tip for dry shampoo, a lot of people struggle because like, oh, I get the white cast. Like, how do I get rid of that? I don't wanna look like I have gray hair. 100% agree with you. The thing is with dry shampoo that people think is that when you spray it in, you gotta comb it out or shake your hair out right away. Do not do that. Spray it in your hair, leave it in your hair for at least 30 seconds to a minute. Let it absorb the oils and everything in your hair, and then comb it out or shake your hair out, however you wanna do it, and you won't see a white cast. If you are a hot or sweaty sleeper at night, I would recommend spraying some dry shampoo in your hair in at night before you go to bed. You don't have to comb it out or anything, but just spray it in your hair where you get greasy, and you won't, it will absorb the oils and everything throughout the night, so that way you're not so greasy in the morning. So that might help you as well too. If you have medium hair, medium to thick hair, I would suggest washing your hair. If you can go 3 days, 4 days without washing, great. If you have thick hair, my thick haired girls tend to go like a week to 2 weeks, which is insane. If you can go to 2 weeks, freaking love you. But I go about a week, so that's on average for me. I go between 5 to 7 days without washing. I never used to be able to do that though. When I first started this process, I would wash my hair probably twice a day in high school. I'd wash my hair because I was a cheerleader and I was always getting so sweaty. And dry shampoo was like not really a thing then. I was washing my hair way too much. I definitely trained myself to get in that process. So now I can go longer without washing my hair. It's a process, you just have to get used to it, but you're in quarantine. Take this time where you're not seeing anybody to just to not wash your hair, and your hair is gonna kind of get on a schedule and it'll understand eventually. Okay, so tip number two, which goes along kind of with tip number one basically, is to make sure that you're using a shampoo conditioner that is paraben and sulfate free. It kind of starts with what's in your shower. If you're using a drugstore shampoo and conditioner that you don't really care about, you're not really sure what it's doing for your hair, it's probably not good for you. A lot of like cheaper end shampoos and conditioners have a lot of like waxes and chemicals in them that are not good for your hair and actually will not help in any way when it comes to like not washing your hair every day and the health of your hair. You might see if you're washing your hair and immediately after you get out of the shower and you blow dry it and you still have like grease and stuff in the back of your head, you have buildup in your hair and it's probably from your shampoo and conditioner. So I would reanalyze that. If you're using really cheap brands, spend the extra money, you guys. It's so worth it in the end just to spend the extra money. I never really wanted to believe that before I became a hairstylist. I was like, that's insane. I'm not spending that much money on shampoo and conditioner, but I totally get it now, and I think it's a huge necessity just to spend the extra money. I'm gonna link some of my favorite shampoos and conditioners and any products I talk about in today's video or any suggestions for you guys will always be linked below in the description box. So go ahead and check down there if you guys are in the market for a new shampoo conditioner. You know, peep the description box. If you want to ask me any questions regarding your hair type and you want to know like, well, what shampoo and conditioner should I use for this type hair, just send me a message on Instagram. It's usually the quickest and I will help you find something that works for you. So I'm always here and happy to help. Tip number 3, super important. You may not like hearing this, but it's a necessity. So please get a haircut. Do not go a huge amount of time not getting a haircut while you're putting so much heat on your hair and you're just kind of damaging it along the way. If you want healthy hair, you need to maintain your haircuts. So I probably get my hair cut every, I would say 3 months I get a trim, which is pretty good for me considering how my hair type is and how much damage I put in my hair. I only get my hair colored once a year. I maintain my haircuts about every 2 to 3 months, I would say, actually, probably 2 months. I'm due for a haircut right now, but I can't get my haircut, so I ain't gonna touch it. But honestly, seriously, you guys, get your haircuts. The reason I say this is some people don't believe that this is a true statement, but it is seriously so true. When you do not cut your hair and you have split ends and dry and brittle ends, they're not going to mend by not cutting your hair. And no lotion, cream, serum, whatever is going to fix that situation. You need to get a haircut. If you don't cut off the damage, it's just going to keep breaking and keep climbing up your hair and your hair is not going to grow any longer. So sometimes when people come into me and they're like a first time client, they're like, well, I'm trying to grow my hair out, but I don't understand why it's not growing out. I'm not doing anything to it, but I am kind of curling it and all these things. It's like, well, because you're not cutting off those dry, brittle, broken ends. They're just keep breaking off and they're climbing up your hair. So honestly, if you want healthy, long mermaid, all that hair we all dream of, please maintain your haircuts. Now, this is dependent on person, so I can't give you guys a number on saying like, well, how often should I cut my hair? It all depends on your hair type and how often you're putting chemical treatments on it. So if you're someone who's blonding your hair like every 4 weeks and your roots come in or something like that, 4 to 6 weeks, I would recommend a haircut. I usually give my clients those kind of haircuts for that hair type. I give my clients like every other color treatment, we do a haircut. So it just depends, you know, my OG clients, my regulars, they know actually, like I tell them when to get a haircut at this point and they trust me. And I'm not actually like saying like cut off like 6 inches every time. I'm saying just give yourself a little dusting, a little trim on the ends, and life will be a lot better and you'll get that hair that you've always dreamed of. Oh my God, it's getting so bright. I gotta move this. So if you guys want to know like how often to cut your hair, consult your hairstylist, talk to them and see what the best option is for you. But yeah, get your hair cut. Get your trims, guys. Get your trims. Tip number 4, lower your heat styling use. So I know it's kind of impossible to basically do a no heat all the time, but if you're someone who uses heat on your hair, let's say like every day, I would kind of try and take that down. So For me, example, I put heat on my hair once a week, and that's usually when I wash my hair if I want to style it. If you guys are an OG here on my channel, you know that I have super natural curly hair. So I sometimes go with just my natural hair, and that's obviously a no heat method. But I pick and choose how I'm going to use heat on my hair, but I only do it once a week if I do want to style my hair. So this style, for instance, I know I'm gonna get questions about it because it's been like all the questions on my Instagram lately. This hairstyle, how I got these waves in my hair is I actually just blow dried my hair with my Revlon styler, and then I actually just braided my hair in a mohawk ponytail in a Dutch braid, and I went to bed like that, and I took it out, and this is what I got. So this has been my like minimal heat method on how I get my hair wavy with a little curl in it. And instead of using a blow dryer and a curling iron, I chose using just a blow dryer, and then I did a no heat method to get some waves. So kind of think about it, think outside of the box, you know, come up with cool different hairstyles for yourself and ways to minimize heat. But if you're using heat every single day, let's try and take that down a little bit, because it's doing more damage on your hair. If you have to use heat on your hair, please make sure you are using a heat protectant. Super important. I'll link my all-time favorite heat protectant down below for you guys. It's from Davinesse. It's called Melu Hair Shield or Heat Shield. I don't remember. I use it every day at the salon. You think I would remember what it's called, but it's called Melu, and it's literally the best heat protectant. I love it. I am a Davinesse hairstylist, so I 100% love Davinesse. I will back it up. That's what I use for color as well. So yeah, that will be linked below if you guys need a heat protectant. But please, if you are using heat on your hair, make sure you are using a heat protectant. It will just keep your hair healthier against using heat. So highly recommend. Okay, sorry, move the camera again because now it's bright and sunny and it looks like a spring day outside. I live in a very weird place. Okay, this is actually an important tip. And if you can do this, I know this is gonna be really hard to do, but if you're someone like me, this might help you. So I would recommend lowering the amount of color treatments you're getting, or try and do like low maintenance hair colors. So balayages are all the rage right now, you know, that like minimalistic, I got my hair bleached like 6 years ago type look, basically what I have. You know, those hair colors will last you a lot longer on your budget, so your wallet will thank you, your hair will thank you too, because it's less damage you're putting on your hair because you're not getting your hair colored all the time. So for me, example, again, I only get my hair colored probably about once a year or every 6 months. It depends on like what I've got going on that year. This year, since I'm getting married in October, I will be getting it every 6 months, but usually it's about like once a year. I love that like grown out balayage look. I think it's beautiful. I think it's complimentary towards a lot of people. So if you can be someone who goes a long time without getting your hair colored, highly recommend it. I know it's tough for some people who have grays and they've got to kind of like fix their roots. Root coverages, that's a whole nother story, and I totally get that. What I would recommend for you is making sure that your hairstylist is using the best possible products on your hair, so that way it's not a lot of chemical on your hair. I, again, am a Davinesse hairstylist, so I use Davinesse hair color as well, and Davinesse is actually a B Corp brand, so we are held to a higher standard than organic, so it's really great color for your hair. It's all made from natural derived products, a lot of it using quinoa protein, so I'm always telling my clients, don't worry, I'm putting really good color on your hair that's actually healthy for it. So that would be my tip, is just to kind of find a hairstylist that uses really good hair care and hair color, so you don't really have to worry. You can just sit there and relax. Okay, so tip number six, this one's actually kind of interesting, and this is something I tell all of my clients, but I don't actually hear a lot of people talking about this tip. I don't know, maybe this is just like something I always talk about, but try to do like a less stress hairstyle. So if you're someone who literally will rock a tight high pony 6 days out of the week, you need to stop that right now. So the more stress you're putting on your hair when you're styling it, it's actually not good. A lot of clients will tell me they see breakage around their hairline, or they have this weird breakage all throughout their head back of the neck kind of thing. And they're like, what is going on? And I'm like, if you're wearing your hair up in a ponytail all the time, it's not doing good for you. It's actually causing breakage because you're pulling the hair in a direction it does not want to go. So try and think of some fun, stressless hairstyles on your hair. You know, hair scrunchies are my favorite thing ever. I give hair scrunchies actually to all of my hand-tied extension clients because it's better for the hair and it doesn't cause creasing or anything like that. But try to get hair tools that are not going to cause stress on your hair. So hair scrunchies, I absolutely love. I also love the phone cord ones. I don't know what those are called, but they look like a phone cord. Love those hair ties. You know, try to find good, you know, quality products to use on your hair. Spend the extra money, you guys. Your hair will thank you. And it's not like you're buying it every week. It's something you're buying once, like maybe a year, because things come in packs like that. So try to think a little bit differently. If you need hair scrunchies, you guys, so many stores are selling hair scrunchies. You can find them everywhere. You can find them on Amazon. I actually love buying Urban Outfitters hair scrunchies because they're just like cool different colors. So I bought a pack from Urban Outfitters recently and I love those. Okay, so tip number 7, do a hair treatment, you guys. You're in quarantine right now. Once a week, do like a special hair treatment on your hair. You know, let it go natural for as long as possible. You know, this is the time to take care of your hair and get the hair you want. So extra hair treatments are so awesome. I will link some of my favorite hair masks for you guys down below. One of my natural favorite hair treatments that I absolutely love that I've actually done a video on here on my channel is a castor oil hair treatment. I love that treatment. If you have medium to thick hair, I would pretty much just say just use castor oil on your hair. I've noticed that some people have had difficulty because castor oil is so thick that I would just say mix it with like coconut oil or almond oil or something like that just to kind of give it a little bit of a thinner consistency. But oil treatments are amazing and castor oil has been known to be a natural hair growth oil. So highly recommend doing those kind of treatments, oil treatments and stuff, because your hair will love you. Just soaking up any moisture that it can get is like super important. Tip number 8 is just less is more. If you are someone who's using like 10 different products on your hair from shower to finish, I would probably tell you to try and take that down a little bit. If you're noticing you're using hair products that are like you're not even sure what it's doing for you, let's kind of reanalyze that situation. I usually recommend 4 to 5 core products to use on your hair, start to finish. So obviously your shampoo and conditioner, a leave-in treatment. If it has a heat protectant in it, that's also a bonus, but a leave-in treatment, a hair oil, and then a heat protectant. So usually those 4 to 5 core products are like all you need for the average everyday person. If you're a curly girl though, girl, I get you. I am naturally curly as well. So that's gonna be a little bit different, and you guys can go check out my curly girl playlist if you want to kind of reference product references for those. And when I style my hair, that's all I use. I use a shampoo, conditioner, leave-in, a hair oil when I finish, and a heat protectant before I finish and I style my hair. But you guys get the gist. So yeah, less is more. Okay, so if you're using like 10 products and you're noticing your hair is heavy, it's got buildup, try and take those products down and delete some items. So yeah. Okay, so tip number 9, and then this is also going to tie into tip number 10, which is going to be the last tip. But tip number 9 is getting yourself a silk or satin pillowcase. Again, I will link products for you guys down below. But super important. Not only is it good for your skin because it can tend to help reduce fine lines and wrinkles. I'm a face musher, so when I sleep at night, I am like in the pillow. So all of that can cause a lot of like not so good things for your skin when it comes to pushing it against like a regular pillowcase, and those tend to hold bacteria and gunk in them when it's just like a regular linen or flannel pillowcase. So silk and satin tend to be like, I don't even know what the difference is between the two materials, but someone else can tell us. But those tend to be better on your skin and they don't hold a lot of bacteria. So I highly recommend getting one of those, not only for your skin, but for your hair, because it doesn't cause a lot of friction. Since it's a lot of slippage, your hair just kind of lays nicely on it. And when you're rolling, and if you tend to be someone who's like a really rough sleeper, I'm a crazy sleeper. I look like I'm having a dance party when I'm sleeping. I love having my silk pillowcase because I can just like, my hair doesn't get frizzy. There's no flyaways in the morning. My hair is still shiny. It's like really, really good for your hair. So highly recommend changing out your pillowcase to one of those. But this also ties into tip number 10, which is the last tip, and that is to sleep with your hair In some type of style. So I tend to sleep with my hair in a braid. I highly recommend kind of coming up with a hairstyle that fits for you. If you can sleep with your hair, usually I say in a braid or a low ponytail is usually best, because, you know, it's not like in a super tight ponytail or anything like that. But just something that's like easy on your hair. And I always go to bed with a scrunchie in my hair, no matter what the hairstyle is. So just keeping your hair tied away is good, because it's going to keep your hair less greasy, because your hair is not falling on your skin. And us women, we like to go to bed with like all of our oils on our faces. So keeping your hair out of your face is key, so you're not waking up with like super greasy hair in the morning. But it just helps kind of keeping your hair out of the way. If you do want to gain volume in your hair, sleeping with your hair with like a high ponytail, using a scrunchie only, please just use a scrunchie. You can get some volume when you take your hair out at the end of the day. I do that when I have curly hair. I do like the pineapple method, so I'll sleep with my hair at the top of my head. The two methods, pillowcase and kind of having your hair tied up a certain way during bedtime, is super essential. So yeah, that's the last from my... Hey guys, so I'm just editing this video and I wanted to hop on here real quick because I didn't really say it in the video and I really wanted to touch base on some extra things for you guys real quick. But if you're ever wondering, people ask me all the time how I've gotten my hair to be so healthy over the last year or so, and how I've gotten it to be so long. And honestly, it's because I followed all of these tips. Since I am a hairstylist, it's kind of natural to do that for me anyways, but I don't get my hair colored that often. I get regular haircuts and I just maintain it with good treatments and stuff and really good products on my hair. So if you follow all of these steps, I swear to you, you will have success with your hair. And the other thing that I just wanted to mention to you guys, because sometimes people are super eager to grow this like 10 inches of hair overnight, and it does not happen that way. So as long as you're patient, this will happen for you. You just have to really work hard at it and be strict and be patient, okay, you guys? So I just want to touch base on that real quick, because as I was editing, I'm like, I didn't really talk about that and I really wanted to make sure I did. So yeah, sorry for the little pop in right here. I just wanted to touch base on that, because as I was editing, I was like, I didn't really talk about being patient at all. And that's like one of the biggest things, is just be patient. So yeah, okay, you guys get the gist. Back to the video. All right, you guys, so now we're going right into my Instagram. You guys have asked me a ton of different questions, so we're just gonna get right into it. Question number one, tips to help length and also thickness. So I've kind of touched base on that a little bit in this video. You know, all of those tips will help you with length and thickness. Thickness, that's also another thing though. If you have super, super fine hair, it's gonna be rare to find something that's gonna make you grow. You can't actually grow like more hair, but try to kind of reanalyze. If you're someone who has super fine hair and you're getting it highlighted every like 6 weeks, and you're also washing it every single day, and you're not using good shampoo and conditioner, there's your reason right there. So you wanna, your highlights can probably stay where they're at, but you know, stop washing your hair every day, use good quality products, and you might notice a huge difference. This is actually a really good question. Sometimes after a few days of not washing my ends, get really dry. Is that a thing? 100%. This is where hair oil comes into play and is super important for everybody to have, especially when you're not washing your hair every day. Hair oil is key. So sometimes I actually even leave my hair oil on my nightstand, but just a little hair oil on your ends every night before you go to bed will do the trick. And I also style with my hair with hair oil every day. So when I took my hair out of the braid this morning, I just ran a little bit of hair oil through my hair and I was good. But every night before you go to bed, I would recommend putting a hair oil through your ends, especially if you have extensions. Super important. All of my hand tied girls go home with a little jar of hair oil, and it's so important. So hair oil on your ends will solve that problem. This kind of touched base to what my hair cutting tip, but if you have a lot of split ends, is it better to chop it off, or is there hope that it can still grow? Definitely give your hair a cut. If you have a ton of breakage and you're looking at your hair and your ends are like all white from the dead and split ends, it's probably going to be time that you give yourself a really good chop. Getting your normal haircuts is going to be super important. So yes, it is time to cut your hair. You don't have to do like a crazy chop. I would consult your hairstylist again. I don't know what your hair like looks like. I can't see it in person, but consult your hairstylist when you're able to go back. And you might need a good chop, or you might just need like 1 to 2 inches off, but definitely maintain good haircuts throughout the year, because your hair will grow immensely. Okay, is it okay that I still get my hair wet on the days I don't wash it? Yes, it's totally okay. This is actually coming from one of my friends, but she has like wavy curly hair. But what she means is like when she's in the shower, she just basically gets her hair wet, but she doesn't put anything in it. Totally okay. I would even recommend running a conditioner through your ends again, because any hydration is good for your hair. So that's not a bad thing. Just add a little conditioner to your ends and you should be good too, if you want to add a little bit of like treatment wise. But if your hair's not greasy and like you don't need it, you know, whatever, just get your hair wet. And if you can, go for it. I get my hair wet all the time when I'm in the shower and I'm going curly and I just want to go a couple days without washing. I still get my hair wet because, as curly girls know, like we need that extra refresh. So totally fine. Do you still use castor oil? If so, how often? And if not, what do you suggest? I still use castor oil. I probably don't use it as often as I was using it a long time ago, because when I was using it, I had really short hair. But now I probably use it maybe like every 2 weeks or so. I'll do a little castor oil treatment. I have fun with it though. Like, I'll mix it with coconut oil. I'll add lavender oil, essential oil to it. You know, I kind of like to have fun with it and make like my own little concoctions, but I love homemade oil treatments. It's like my favorite thing. And if I don't use castor oil, I'll just use an shower hair mask. I love Way's hair mask. It's amazing. I will link it below. And Davinesse's new hair mask. If you have really brittle hair, that's an amazing hair mask as well. Can you do my hair every day of the week, please? And thank you. I would love to do that. Okay. How do you find the right cut that suits your hair type, face, and style? That is a really good question. So I would kind of just like, when you're looking for inspiration, and this kind of goes for hair color as well too. So when you're looking for inspiration, whether you're on Pinterest or Google or whatever, and you're looking for like that good hairstyle to show your hairstylist, always search for someone who has similar features to you. You know, you can always Google or search like haircuts for long face shapes, haircuts for square face shapes. Like, look at people that have very similar features to you. You'll kind of know what that cut and style that's on them, how it would look on you. Usually when I search out like inspiration for myself, I always look for someone who has like more of an oval face shape, dark hair, dark eyes, dark eyebrows, and it just kind of helps me kind of envision what it would look like on myself. But I would just kind of like look at inspiration photos and look at people that look similar to you or like have similar features. Don't be afraid to like ask like your hairstylist or close friends and family what they think would look good on you, because sometimes a fresh pair of eyes can maybe open your eyes to something that you weren't even thinking about before. So that's always something to think about. Camera almost died, you guys. I had to put in a new battery. Sorry. Hi, I'm back. Okay. Next question. Okay, there are so many shampoos out there. What's your fave that you can buy at Target or something like that? Okay, going back to basically using good hair care products, I highly recommend using like, you know, salon grade, really good products. And always, this is also another thing, always buy your hair care from a professional or from a professional place. If you have to go to Sephora or Ulta, that's fine. Buy it, you know, there, or buy it with your hairstylist. Actually, buying your hair care with your hairstylist is so beneficial for them, more than you think. So buy it with a professional. Don't go buying, you know, Paul Mitchell at your local grocery store, because guess what? It is not real. That is actually fake product. And if you read the back, it says this product may be tampered with. So don't buy products at your local grocery store, because it's old and it's gross and you really shouldn't use it. Also, be careful on Amazon. Don't buy products like that on Amazon either, because they're also not real sometimes too. So just be really, really careful where you're buying your products. If you're buying Moroccan oil off Amazon and it's coming from Moroccan oil itself, then you're good. But if you're buying Moroccan oil from some random Joe Schmo on Amazon, might not be real. So make sure you're doing your research and you're buying from a credible place. But also, if you want to buy from Target or something like that, my favorite brand is Kristen S. You guys have seen me talk about her brand before. She is an actual hairstylist herself, so I do trust in her to know that her products are good quality ingredients. And I have used her hair care products and I absolutely love them. I use her Curly Girl line for my curls and I 100% swear by her products. They're amazing. So if you have to use a brand that is from like a drugstore or particularly Target, I would recommend Kristen S. Absolutely love her stuff. It's amazing. I had to recommend a different brand and more pro grade. I love my tried and true Davin S. is honestly amazing. It just makes the hair so much better and my client's hair comes back so nice after doing colors and stuff and like weeks without seeing them. It's just really good hair care line. So Davin S. is one of my top favorites. I also love Way and I love Orbe and I could go on and on, but I will link some of my favorites down below for you guys. But again, if you need help finding, you know, the right products for you, just shoot me a message and we'll talk. So how to master the beach loose wave. I love this question. I think I've done like so many hair videos in the past, but I could definitely do another one. I mean, this one I just basically did like a braid in my hair, but doing it with like a curling iron, I just recommend don't leaving the curling iron on that long. If you want that like wave look, you know, just kind of wind it on or twirl it like once or twice around the iron and leave it on for like 5 seconds and take it out and then comb your hair out and you'll just get that like nice bend wave look in your hair. Altering different directions will do the trick too because it won't look super consistent and it won't stick together. So that's my two tips, you know, don't leave it on long and comb it out after it's out of the curling iron and then do it like altering directions. If you guys want a video, I'll do a video for you guys if you want like hair tutorial. Okay, so this is a good question. How to conceal my grays if I wanna go longer in between seeing my hairstylist. So I would recommend getting like a hair powder or a hair like color root spray. Those are always amazing. I love Color Wow. Color Wow is actually a brand that I use personally. It's just really, really good. Covers your roots so well. It comes in like a compact. If you buy like the actual kit for yourself, it comes in like a little compact. You can take it with you, has a mirror, a little brush, and you can cover your grays. It doesn't like conceal them entirely, but it does give good coverage. So I just recommend like a hair powder or like a root spray, and it does the trick and washes out when you take a shower. But that also can help you if you want to go longer without having to see your hairstylist. One thing I want to stress now that we are all stuck home and we cannot see our hairstylist, although we miss you and love you so, so, so much, we also want to stress to you to please don't touch your hair. Don't put box color on it. Don't put, you know, whatever you find. Please just leave your hair alone. During this time, I cannot stress it enough because honestly, you're going to be paying more in the salon to fix it than to just leave it alone. So highly recommend leaving your hair alone during this time. You guys, if you can, please, 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 please do that. I know every hairstylist that could be watching this video is like, thank you for saying that because honestly, just leave it. Okay. So this last question I actually love so much. I should have touched base on this when I was talking about shampoos, but it's a great question. So first she asked best shampoos. So again, links will be below, but then her other question was best ways to deep clean your hair once a week. And this is actually super important. So I would highly suggest that you guys, if you are someone who's going to be using a lot of products on your hair, if you are, and you're going to be transitioning to kind of decrease some of those products, or if you're gonna be using a lot of dry shampoo, kind of training your hair to washing it less, I would highly suggest getting a clarifying shampoo. Clarifying shampoos are super important because they're gonna break down all of that buildup that's currently on your hair and kind of just give it like that deep, deep cleanse that everyone needs. So I will link my favorite clarifying shampoo below for you guys if you are in the market to get one. But super important, it just helps kind of really cleanse and get all the gunk out. Especially if you're using dry shampoo a lot, highly recommend. There's also like scalp scrubs out there. I've never tried them though, and I've actually been very curious. So I will link some like high rated ones if you guys are wanting to try a scalp scrub, feel free. But yeah, I will link those below for you guys. But I would just say like a general clarifying shampoo will do the trick. All right, you guys, that's basically it for today's video. That's all I have for my tips and tricks. I don't really have much things to tell you guys. Just take care of your hair. That's basically all that comes down to it. But I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned maybe one or two new things today. I know a lot of this stuff probably was repetitive. You probably hear it all the time, but it's all true. It all sticks to how to get healthy hair, you know? So regardless, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and thank you to those of you who did ask questions. I loved that so much. And yeah, if you guys have any questions, anything that I didn't touch base on in today's video, feel free to reach out. I'm always, you know, on Instagram, or you can reach out down below in the comment section. And again, links will be below for any products that you guys might be in the market for. I will link everything and anything that I can think of for you guys will be in the description box. So yeah, that's basically it today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I love you guys so much. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I will see you guys very soon. Bye.